And with me, I have Viktor Vekselberg, head of Renova Investments, a big investor here in Russia, one of Russia's richest men. Let me start by asking you about what's happening in Greece and what it means for Russia.
I think everybody understands this is Greece become to a very serious financial crisis. And we should understand that Russia is part of the global economy, and any sharp situation, what can be going on the European market, automatically get impact of Russian financial market. Yesterday we see not the big valuation of our market, but I think it's all investors today to have some concern about what is going on with euro, with dollar.
And obviously what happens in the European Union has a consequence for how investors look at emerging markets like Russia.
I think it's Russia all time to demonstrate a more stable situation compared with emerging market. And I think it's very important to understand that Russia this year to demonstrate a stable growing. And yesterday our premier to announce a very ambitious plan for Russian economy, says they would like to gets a number fifth position in the next 10 years.
And part of that, you're championing the government's plan to build a sort of Silicon Valley here, to reduce dependence on oil. And that, a lot of analysts say, is an important thing. Can you really do that in Russia where everything depends on oil? And
I see your smile. We can really do this. Believe me.
I'm a tad skeptical.
I believe this is a government that's very serious to look into diversification of Russian economy, reduce dependability from oil, gas, raw material, and some metal. And this call called one-off, I would like to say one-off of that example. Uh-huh. And our project demonstrated it very stable growth, it very a lot of proposal from our international partners. I would like to say that during the St. Petersburg Forum, we're looking to sign number of new agreement with big company.
You've got a bit more than a 7% stake in Rusal, the world's largest aluminum maker. What's the future hold for Rusal? Is this commodities boom that's been driving the growth at Rusal going to continue?
I just would like to say, if you just to see back to Rusal, like even the 1 year ago, we see a lot of concern around the company because the company had a lot of debt. But at the same time, today, we see that we have the real opportunity to restructure our debt until end of year. I think we'll be reach the level that less than 3x our EBITDA. It means company again will be ready to pay dividends for shareholders. And I would like to say that our forecast for aluminum price for future on the LME and demand of the global market, it looks very attractive.
You said dividends. What kind of return on your investment would you like to see? Because obviously you got a little bit of a return in the form of dividends before the crisis, but not much since then.
I don't want to say it's a little dividends before the crisis. It was reasonable level
and
of
now,
dividends. And now we have zero.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And what would be fair going forward?
No, I think we have the policy of dividends. It's up to 50% of our net income. And I believe this will be a good result for ordinary investment.
Would you consider selling some of your stake now that Rusal has had the IPO?
No. We don't look in that way.
You're one of the four Russian billionaires at TNK BP that is partnered up with BP. Now, what is the relationship like between BP and yourself and your three partners here in Russia? I mean, it can't be great.
I think it's good enough. We should understand this is just like this is exactly business case. I would like to say that the Russian investors of the TNK BP just would like to protect shareholder industry. This is our main behavior.
Hand on heart, can you tell me at the end of 2011, Viktor Vekselberg won't have sold his stake to either BP or Rosneft? Can you promise me that?
I cannot to promise because I am a businessman. It will depends on
everything has a price.
Proposition. Absolutely.
They offered you $32
billion. I think it's now we're not looking to sell, but again, if there will be an interesting proposal, why not?
All right, thank you, Mayor. We're going to have to leave it there. Viktor Vekselberg, head of Renova Investments, as you just heard there, obviously also a stakeholder in Russia's third largest oil company, TNK BP. Back to you.